ladies and gentlemen. Despite the great progress in the diagnostic and therapy of AIDS, there are still many unanswered questions. Without giving the answer to these questions, more successful treatment of patients can be expected. A strong argument for this prediction is the fact that we are still not able to stop worldwide prevention of AIDS, especially in Africa and Asia. The data leading to conclusion that HIV alone is the etiologic agent responsible for AIDS is generally accepted. According to this claim, virus was transferred to human from monkeys in Africa through random contacts about 35, 50 years ago. But this claim was not sufficiently confirmed. Plasma HIV RNA is dramatically reduced in patients treated with heart therapy, but residual viral replication is detected after suppression of viral viremia. It has also been proven that various forms of HIV reservoirs are present in practically all patients receiving this therapy. These reservoirs were detected mainly in a cell or blood system. As is claimed in recent studies, the range of viral reservoirs in the human body is very probably much wider. The source of persistent HIV in infected person remains, however, unclear. There is an increase of evidences that pointed out that in the gut and or the mucosal tissue and not in the blood is the main place of HIV infection and CD4 T cell loss. This finding goes along with new studies on the role of bacterial translocation in the gut as a central driver of AIDS pathogenesis. This interest of investigation bacteria and mycoplasma in this disease was also supported by Montagnier findings confirmed by Xinxi Guo that mycoplasma is a very important cofactor which accelerates the progression of HIV infection in AIDS patients. Bacteria in AIDS represent second kingdom in our body. The fact that the balance between these two kingdoms is the base of our existence is still underestimated. This balance, established for many, many centuries, was during the last decade seriously disrupted by application of antibiotics, pharmaceuticals, drug, and changes in lifestyle. There are no studies on the role of bacteria in disease associated with AIDS. It demonstrates clearly that bacteria can induce in the gut and vagin transcription of some silent genes, including HIV-1 provirus. The HIV has also been detected in bowel crypt cells and lamina propria. Since these cells are close nearly to intestinal bacteria, the idea that bacteria can be involved in pathogenesis of AIDS is justified. Bacteria are a strong candidate for viral reservoirs in the human body. These findings are challenging us to fight against AIDS in a more complex manner. It's highly desirable to overcome all dogmas and taboos surrounding this disease. In advance, it is necessary to deliberate what a potential factor, not only HIV, which may take part in this disease. Our approach, we studied the role of bacteria in AIDS in bovine leukemia and consequently in AIDS process for more than 25 years. This approach is based on detection, BLV-like sequences in bacteria isolated from BLV-positive animals. Gradually, we identify HIV-like sequences in the laboratory of Professor Flossivong Stahl in San Diego, and later HIV-like protein in bacteria and yeast in a cohort of 80 HIV-positive patients from Slovakia, United States, Kenya, and Cambodia. We use for detection HIV-like proteins and HIV-like sequences, classical method, colony and dot blot hybridization, PCR sequences, Western blotting, and gentamicin protection assay. Here is a result of a dot bot hybridization of lymphocyte and bacterial DNA from AIDS patient. As a probe was used, PCR product 60S69-39 synthesized on template of patient lymphocyte DNA. Here is a PCR product 1,500 synthesized on template bacterial DNA of AIDS patient. We prepared around 500 of PCR product on a template of bacteria isolated from AIDS or HIV positive patient. About 300 from them were sequencing, and we obtained identity to HIV isolate for 84-94%. Here is some sequences of 348 PCR products synthesized on template of bacterial DNA. Identity 95% with HIV isolate. Here is a comparison of sequences determined by primer 60S69 from M gene. It's a bacteria. This is a DNA from lymphocyte DNA from bacteria, and so on. Here is a Western blotting of protein isolated from bacteria of respiratory tract of Cambodian and Kenyan HIV positive children. Detection was performed using monoclonal antibodies against HIV-1-GP41. Here is Western blotting of proteins isolated from bacteria of respiratory tract of Cambodian and Kenyan positive children. Detection was performed using monoclonal antibodies against P24. You see here is a P24, and detected proteins are about 55 kilodalton, that may represent 55 GAC precursor. And here is a Western blot protein from bacteria respiratory tract of Cambodia and Kenyan HIV positive children. Detection was performed by using monoclonal antibodies against P55, P17. And finally, here is a Western blotting of proteins isolated from bacteria in yeast of respiratory tract, Cambodian and Kenyan, using monoclonal antibodies and GP120. There is a little small difference between this protein and the references protein. I can conclude that we detect in Candida species isolated from AIDS patient practically all proteins, including glycoprotein, because Candida are able to synthesize a glycoprotein. So that I think that infection of respiratory tract by Candida is rather very dangerous. Afterwards, we internalize HL60 cells by bacteria of AIDS patient and bacteria from patients from colorectal tumors. You see here the amount of bacteria colonies is 10, 20 times higher than amount of bacteria isolated when you use bacteria from cancer patient. And here is an internalization of normal human lymphocytes by bacteria from AIDS patient. You see that very high affinity of these bacteria to lymphocytes. There are many of bacteria colony, 1,000 and so on, but mostly normal lymphocyte pair lice. Afterwards, we treated 20 HIV-positive patients with probiotic by bacterial missile 1917, and decrease of viral load after 3 months of probiotic treatment was 44%, and 11 patients from 20 viral load was decreased. The origin of HIV, according to our and other result, there is a strong objection against generally accepted dogma that HIV was transferred to human from apes in Africa about 35, 50 years, according the least assertion, about 100 years ago on the road of accidental contact. I think that I am not able to accept this dogma because as a result of some accidental contact, either 35 million of HIV positive people were right. That can be true. Epidemiologically, it's absolutely nonsense. So that's good news from me to Africa. And there is not evidence about transmission of retrovirus between two different species in nature. Should be HIV one exception? The problem is that acceptation of these dubious arguments have a major influence to research, diagnostic, and therapy of AIDS. How is it possible that this inconvincing dogma was accepted by most experts? Our hypothesis, HIV is an integral part of humans since the beginning of our existence. We inherited it from our ancestors. Bacteria and yeast are more likely natural hosts of HIV sequences. But there is a serious objection. If HIV was in our body from our beginning, why did he emerge just about 25, 35 years ago? To answer this question, we should go back into the ancient history of humankind. In the past, more epidemics frequently occurred when there were new patterns of transport between separately populated areas and new patterns of settlement. This tremendous long time, we call it sanitary process, take place mainly in Europe, consequently United States, GB and GB colonies, partially in Asia and in North Africa, and resulted in establishment of balance between these two kingdoms in human population. The victim was, as we think, mostly people with bacteria bearing HIV sequences. This balance was interrupted, intestinal dysbiosis, on the middle of 20th century due to application of antibiotics, drug, including recreational medicines and changing in lifestyle, propagated HIV-bearing pathogenic microbes in the majority to antibiotic resistance with the ability to penetrate into the body. When bacteria carrying HIV sequences with a high affinity to lymphocytes penetrate into blood, infected or lyse them, consequently, immune system collapse. The result of this process is AIDS. Our hypothesis is based on respectation of central role of HIV genetic information in the process of AIDS. But I don't agree with dogma HIV is AIDS. Claims that bacteria and yeast are more likely natural hosts of HIV genetic information. Recommendation that in AIDS is necessary to deliberate other potential factors, not only HIV, which may take a part of this disease and may be different in various groups. Assumption that transmission of HIV from AIDS to human during last decades in Africa as a consequence of some accidental contact is not the cause of AIDS. Here is a very important one phenomenon. Very high frequency of CCR5 mutation in European population. That's basically in the northern part of Europe. According to epidemiological study, this was very probably induced by bubonic plague epidemics in 1346. This was the biggest epidemic in Europe at the time, about 40 million died just only in Europe. About 60 million people died in China and Korea and Mongolia. The question is, why? Here is these people bearing CCR5 mutations survive and they amplify. Maybe that answer, there are many possible answers, but one answer suitable for us, of course, is that at that time, HIV was in human population. Now we are able to answer to many anti-Lovance questions. I spoke about origin of HIV, large-scale HIV positivity in Africa. Africa is special. People were living in Africa for many centuries in isolated areas. There were no new pattern of transportation between separately populated areas and new pattern settlement. So there were no sanitary process. That's why there's a large HIV positivity in Africa, I think, and there is an absence of gold standard in Africa. In the United States, is a situation that origin, inhabitants, Indian, they practically liquidate, and afterwards, immigrants were coming from Europe. These people were going through sanitary process. But there were two risky group of people. That's the people, their grandparents were transported from Africa to America, and these people were not going through the sanitary process. When these people are going to use drugs and anal sex, so afterwards, they are very risky group of people. Of course, the same risky people are people who accepted generally drug and anal sex. Presence of HIV reservoir, when we accept idea that HIV sequences are in bacteria afterwards, it's impossible to liquidate them because these bacteria are mostly multi-resistant to antibiotics, multi-resistant to antiretroviral therapy, and they are still survive. Variety of complete viral particle detection. If bacteria are bearing HIV sequences, afterwards we have fragments of HIV in bacteria. Usually, in bacteria are not complete viral particle. We never detect LTR in this bacteria. In, of course, in Candida species, we were detected glycoproteins, both glycoproteins. These glycoproteins were not detected in normal bacteria, only in yeast. On the end, I know that my voice is a voice of someone in desert, so that it's not easy for us to find a collaborator, but still it's necessary for us. It's my duty to present our result because who is important for us? Patient. Thank you for your attention.